Hello, I'm Sebastian. Welcome to Nine Gnar Trees podcast. Today I will summarize and review the book. In How to Trick Yourself into Doing Things You Hate, Use Psychology, Self-Discipline, and Neuroscience to Suffer Less, Live a Disciplined Life, Book 18. Peter Hollins presents a compelling and insightful exploration into the mechanics of self-discipline, motivation, and behavior modification. Drawing from the latest research in psychology and neuroscience, Hollins goes beyond mere self-help platitudes to offer practical strategies for tackling procrastination, inertia, and the general reluctance to do tasks we find unpleasant or challenging. This book is not just about enduring the unavoidable, but transforming our approach to what we dislike, making the journey towards productivity and personal growth less about suffering and more about strategic self-empowerment. I will give you key takeaways from this book. Firstly, understanding the psychology of procrastination. Procrastination is more than just laziness or poor time management. It's a complex psychological behavior that involves delaying tasks despite knowing there will be negative consequences. Hollins delves into the roots of procrastination, explaining how it is often a coping mechanism for anxiety, fear of failure, or perfectionism. He discusses how the immediate gratification of avoiding an unpleasant task reinforces procrastination habits. By understanding the underlying psychological factors, readers can begin to unravel their procrastination patterns and develop strategies to overcome them, leveraging insights from cognitive behavioral therapy and mindfulness practices. Secondly, leveraging self-discipline. Strategies. Self-discipline is framed not as an innate trait, but a skill that can be developed through practice and intentionality. Hollins introduces several techniques for strengthening self-discipline, such as setting clear, achievable goals, developing routines, and creating an environment conducive to productivity. He emphasizes the importance of small wins and the cumulative effect they have on building self-discipline. This segment explores how breaking tasks into smaller, more manageable steps can reduce overwhelm and make the process of tackling disliked tasks more palatable. Thirdly, applying neuroscience to overcome resistance, Hollins interweaves concepts from neuroscience to explain why we resist certain tasks and how we can rewire our brains to approach them differently. This includes discussing the role of dopamine in motivation and how altering our reward systems can incentivize actions we typically avoid. By understanding the brain's response to reward and punishment, readers can learn to manipulate their internal reward system, tricking the brain into finding pleasure in previously dreaded tasks through gamification, positive reinforcement, and the strategic use of habit formation techniques. Fourthly, the role of environmental cues in task avoidance. The environment plays a crucial role in shaping our behavior and can either facilitate or hinder our task engagement. Hollins discusses how environmental cues trigger specific behaviors and how altering these cues can change our habits. Strategies such as redesigning physical spaces to reduce distractions, using technology mindfully, and creating visual reminders can help align our surroundings with our goals. This section explores the psychology of environmental influences on behavior and practical steps for creating a productive environment that supports rather than detracts from accomplishing disliked tasks. Lastly, Hollins addresses the importance of mindset in sustaining long-term behavior change. He distinguishes between a fixed mindset and a growth mindset, illustrating how the latter can significantly impact one's ability to persevere through challenges and continue performing tasks they dislike. This chapter emphasizes resilience, the power of yet, and seeing effort and struggle as necessary components of growth. By cultivating a growth mindset, individuals can reframe their approach to disliked tasks from one of avoidance to one of opportunity for learning and self-improvement. In conclusion, Peter Hollins's How to Trick Yourself into Doing Things You Hate is a valuable resource for anyone looking to enhance their productivity, overcome procrastination, and engage in tasks they've historically avoided with distaste. The strategies outlined are grounded in the latest psychological and neuroscientific research, making them both effective and practical for everyday application. This book is particularly suited for individuals who feel stuck in their habits of avoidance and want to cultivate a disciplined life that aligns with their goals and values. By applying the principles Hollins discusses, readers can significantly reduce the suffering associated with disliked tasks and move towards a more proactive, disciplined, and fulfilling life. If you would like to support Peter Hollins, you can buy the book through the Amazon link I've provided in the podcast description. After reading the book, please let me know what you think and share your thoughts. See you around.